This video is brought to you by the Women in STEM Education and Women in Trading Technology summer programs hosted by Jane Street. If you're a woman who's studying a STEM subject at university, either now or you're about to start, or I mean, if you just know someone who matches that description, there'll be more details about those free summer programs both in the description below and at the very end of this video. Today I want to talk about impossible cogs, starting with that educational poster. You may have seen this on the internet. People get very excited whenever it pops up, and as a teacher, I loved this. This, which is why I hunted down my own copy. So in short, you can see, it says here that education works best when all the parts are moving. Can't disagree with that. And then to illustrate it, they've got some cogs. Let me break this down for you. So we've got one cog representing students that could be moving in, let's say, a clockwise direction, and students are meshed nicely with teachers, so they would be moving in a anti-clockwise or counterclockwise direction, perfectly in unison, or at least they would if parents weren't jammed in the corner here, grinding the whole system to a halt. You know, as an ex-teacher, this is very accurate in my experience. So anyway, so if teachers are going anti-clockwise, they're meshing with parents, which means they would have to go clockwise, but they're also meshing with students, they have to go anti-clockwise. This system wouldn't work. Whenever you have three cogs like this and you jam them all together, they cannot move. In fact, any odd number of cogs in a ring like this won't work. The UK £2 coin famously has a ring of 19 cogs, an odd number, and because they have to alternate clockwise, anti-clockwise, effectively there are two cogs that want to go the same direction, but they're meshed together, and so that ain't not going nowhere. If you've read my book Humble Pie or watched the lectures I've given recently at the Royal Institution or at Google, you know I'm obsessed with having an odd number of cogs and how it's impossible for it to work mechanically. Well, there's been a breakthrough in how not quite impossible it might be. It's very exciting. But first of all, to recap, there's another way people try and get around the odd number of cogs problem, and it's by using an extra dimension. So this was on a poster in Manchester when they were bringing out a new public transport system. It's all very funny. People online have argued it only doesn't work from this particular point of view, and if you rotate it around in 3D, that works fine. So a friend of mine, Sabetta, actually made this render for me to demonstrate the argument. Actually, Sabetta was the person I worked with in the video on the hyperbolic space virtual reality. It's worth checking out, absolutely incredible. I'll put a link to that in the description, but she made this rendering for me, and it's, you know, it's a very nice demonstration of the argument. But I find that very unsatisfying as a way to get an odd number of cogs to work, because first of all, you're just breaking the loop. You've no longer got a complete loop of an odd number of cogs, you've just turned it into a line, and that's not very good. And secondly, it only works as an out if you're looking at a picture of cogs that are perfectly flat. If they're at all 3D already, it doesn't work. You haven't got a bonus dimension to use. This is one of the few times I'm not going to allow use of the fourth dimension. So something like this, where you've got 3D cogs, you can't use the you're not looking at it from the wrong angle argument. This was actually a diagram done by USA Today when early on in the Trump administration they were trying to renegotiate the North American Free Trade Agreement. And I don't know if USA Today were trying to get across that none of the parts are moving or they move together easily, but whatever the case, they're not going anywhere and there's no spare dimension to fix it. And I actually paid money to USA Today to license that image so I could put it in my book solely so I could then use the caption, "Making cogs great again." I've also got some stuff in here about how I chatted to the guy who actually designed the £2 coin and a bunch of other stuff on cogs. And finally, these sorts of ridiculous cogs that Henry Segerman makes, no, they do not count. Yes, there may be an odd number of them, but no, they're not real cogs. If you have an odd number of standard issue normal cogs in a closed loop, I have always maintained that is impossible. Until one day, I saw this tiny animated GIF. This low-res GIF of a Mobius loop of cogs moving in unison made me think, could that be possible? Would that work? And then I saw on Reddit, a user named ElminsCosplay was trying to 3D print a Mobius loop of cogs. So I sent them a message, and unbelievably, they already watched my videos. Maybe not unbelievably. You know, actually, no, totally unsurprisingly, the sort of person who was trying to 3D print a Mobius loop of cogs already subscribed to my channel. They said they were trying to perfect it, and would I like a set? I mean, that is a rhetorical question, and here it is, they've got it working. This is a working Mobius loop. So I get this rotating, there it is, look at that. Chain of cogs, that's an odd number of cogs, and it works perfectly. But did they stop there? Oh no, they also 3D printed and sent me a mechanized base. There is the mechanized base. This bit here spins around, and when you sit this on top, it is largely held in place with magnets, except in here, where that drive cog meshes with the one behind, that has a tendency to lift off. So to hold it down firmly and keep it spinning, there's a single screw that goes in the back here. So there's one hex screw that goes on there that holds it in place when it's in the mounted setup. And if I turn that on. Look at that! Look at it go! In total, the mechanism does two laps to make the Mobius loop, and if you start counting from this purple one, because it goes purple, yellow, purple, yellow, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, an odd number of cogs, and you can see it alternates purple, yellow, purple, yellow, apart from that one mesh point right at the back here. So there's the only, oh, be careful, there's a lot of pinch points on this. There's the only purple to purple meshing. So there you are, 15 cogs, all moving in unison. Each time it goes around, it does a quarter of a twist. So by the time it gets back, it's done a full half twist. And that is the secret for why this actually works. So if I have that yellow cog there, right in front of you, from your point of view, that's currently going anti-clockwise. However, if I take that cog and I turn it around the other way, now it's going clockwise. And that's why it works. The last cog is going the wrong way, but it's also turned over. So from the first cog's point of view in a chain, it's not going anti-clockwise, it's going clockwise, or whatever the case may be. And so the half twist means that this only works with an odd number of cogs. Absolutely amazing. I get it, you just want to watch the cogs spin, and that's fine. I will leave that running while I thank my channel's principal sponsor, Jane Street. Specifically in this video, the Women in STEM Education and Women in Trading Technology summer programs that Jane Street are hosting in London this summer. Because as well as supporting my channel and helping me make fantastic mathematics videos, they also support making STEM as accessible as possible. So if you're a woman of any definition and you're going to study a STEM subject after the summer, you can apply to go to the Women in STEM Education program. And if you're accepted, Jane Street will cover everything. It's free. They'll pay for your accommodation, your travel, your food. You'll get to meet loads of other people who will also be studying STEM at university soon. And you'll get to see how things like maths and computer science and probability are used in the real world, in industry, how Jane Street used them to solve complex financial problems. That program goes from the 18th to the 20th of August. And if you've just finished school, you've not got much on in summer, so you can go along. Although the deadline to apply is the 22nd of July, which is very soon. The link's in the description, get onto it. Or if you know someone who's about to go and study STEM at university, send the link to them. The Women in Trading Technology program is very similar, but it's for people who are already at university studying a STEM subject. So if you'd like to know more about quantitative trading or software engineering, you can apply to go on this Jane Street program. It runs a bit later, it's the 8th to the 11th of September, but you need to get your application in by the 5th of August. So if you know anyone who would benefit from either of these free programs, please do check out the details below and send it to them. Or if it's you, please apply, go along, meet loads of other people who are studying the same subjects as you.